Hello all, welcome to the Truth Show. In this Truth Seeker requested video, I will be talking about Vivica Fox. What happened to her? What happened to the sex vixen? When did it all begin to fall for her? Let's talk. Here we go again. I mean, this is the Truth Show and there's more. Oh, I'm not done yet. Oh, and there's more. Oh, I'm not done yet. I mean, this is the Truth Show. Oh, yes. Vivica and Janetta Fox was born on July 30th, 1964 in South Bend, Indiana to Evelyn, who was a pharmaceutical technician, and also to William Fox, who was a private school administrator. She's mixed with African American and Native American ancestry. Her family later moved to Michigan. Vivica graduated from Arlington High School in Indianapolis and later at Golden West College in Huntington Beach, California, with a double A degree in social sciences. Yes, my girl has a degree. But like many of us, we don't use that degree to make money. Viv later, while attending Golden West College, she appeared on Soul Train from 1983 to 1984. That landed to some acting gigs, and she made her appearance on Days of Our Lives in 1988, playing a character named Selva. That parlayed into many other roles, except for one comedy series, Living Dolls, a spinoff of the sitcom Who's the Boss, but was replaced with Halle Berry for the remaining of the episodes. This replacement and overlook what happened throughout Vivica Fox's career. I mean, Halle Berry and her always kind of crossed paths somewhat. Oh, yes. Like, for example, she played Queen of Sheba in a British television film, Solomon, in 1997. I thought she did very well. But guess who else was in this movie? Yes, Halle Berry. Holly's pretty face, killer body, and wavy hair was taking over. But the diva and hustler never stopped. She kept appearing in many TV shows, movies, all over Lifetime, Netflix, and skits here and there. She was making a coin, okay? Holly didn't mess her up that much. So what's really going on? Okay, aside for her being married once in 1998 to singer Christopher 6ix9ine Harvest, they stayed married until 2002. Then there was one Tuesday night in 2007 on a freeway in her Cadillac Sports utility vehicle. After passing a marked police car going 80 miles per hour, faster than the speed limit, she also wasn't able to stay in the correct lane, according to their arrest report from the California Highway Patrol. Then after being stopped, the actress was unable to perform the sobriety test, and her breath indicated a blood alcohol level over the legal limit of 0.08%, the report stated anyway. Then there's the infamous sex tape scandal. Yeah, she had one. Did you guys know that? It was a tape of Fox performing oral sex on her knees to her friend. It is alleged that her friend secretly filmed Vivica one time and then emailed the phone footage to all of his friends. It was rumored that she tried to report it to the Atlanta police, but the Atlanta police at the time, who was James Polite, he was head of that district there, he denied that this incident had ever been reported. He also included that if this boyfriend or friend was trying to extort Vivica, then it will be a case. But she didn't want to fuel the flame, so Vivica probably just didn't say anything. Then it's the famous relationship with Motor Mouth Fire starter 50 Cent. Well, they started dating in 2003. Yes, a year and a half after her divorce. You know, I have to admit, I can't see why any woman who will be interested in 50 Cent. First of all, he looks like he goes upside a woman's head occasionally, okay? He definitely isn't the faithful type. And oh, and every time you fight, you have to worry about if the Motor Mouth slash Firestarter slash Mr. Sensitive. I mean, it seems you have to worry about him blabbing it all over social media. Like, dating a big, spoiled, demonic, confused child. Just nerve-wracking. Anyway, I just had to get that out of the way. Now, let's talk about their relationship. In the beginning, Vivica had nothing but sweet nothings to say about 50 Cent. In a book obtained by People, she writes about how cherished and special their intimate moments were. Here's what she said. Most of the time, I would be the one initiating sex because I really enjoy making love to him. Mm-hmm. Now, you would think this would be a great gesture in memory, but we're talking about Motor Mouth fire starter 50 Cent. And the sensitive man child had this to say upon hearing this. I'm waking up to this S. That was 14 years ago, shaking my head. Who does this? What the F? No. Then there was September 2005, whereas Vivica opened up to Tyra Banks on her show about why she felt she'd been painted in the press as the bad guy after the breakup. Here's what she said. This is what happened to her career, believe it or not. No, it wasn't the press. It was him, she told Banks, adding that he'd been accusing her of using their relationship as a publicity stunt, and later included that the accusations was just consider that ghetto love, and it was his way of dealing with the breakup, and that he was the love of her life. It seems like she had nothing but good things to say about him, but he was bad mouthing her. I mean, this is how 50 Cent roll. I don't know how any woman could deal with him. Anyway, and then in December of 2009, 50 Cent himself took to Banks' couch years later to reveal that he and a longtime ex Fox had smoothed things over. He said during the show that he even offered Fox a spot in one of his music videos. It was an offer she accepted, and the next year she portrayed no other than his ex. Yes, his ex. In a video for his song, Do You Think About Me? I know, unbelievable. But years later, Fox and 50 Cent resurrected their bad blood in 2015 when she outwardly questioned his sexuality on national television. You may all remember this. You see, the controversy first started in October of 2015 when Fox made an appearance on Watch What Happens Live. Host Andy Cohen asked Fox about 50 Cent's now deleted Instagram post that blamed Empire's dip in ratings on plot lines that feature too much gay stuff. Mm-hmm. Fox replied, first of all, you know, the pot called the kettle black is all I'm saying. Which led viewers to believe she was insinuating that 50 Cent was gay, and added, we had a great time. He just seems like he's got something that's not quite clear. Yeah. Now, of course, Motor Mouth fire starter slash Mr. Sensitive had to respond to this rumor that was floating around long before the relationship. Here's what he said in response to Vivica via social media, sharing unflattering photos like he always does. He's like a child, including one of her donning a low-cut dress with the words really bad boob job written all over the picture. I mean, this really hit a nerve, okay? I mean, he got really upset with this. He wasn't done yet. He also said this. B, remember when you told me F Halle Berry and you could have played all the roles she did better than her? And I just looked at you like, what the F kind of F did you take? LMAO. He wrote alongside the photo. Then later took to Twitter to call Fox crazy. Okay. Fox later told People magazine this. I voice my opinion, but I'm the kind of person where if you don't stand for something, you'll fall for anything. I was just really, really sick and tired of hearing the BS about Empire, and especially about the gay storyline, and I'm not going to take it back. Because Lee Daniels, Taraji, and Terrence Howard are very good friends of mine, and they are my co-stars, and I'm a stand-up kind of babe, so I stood up for them, and I don't regret it whatsoever. Mm-hmm. Go ahead, girl. And don't think that Motor Mouth slash Firestarter slash Mr. Sensitive didn't respond back. Here's what he said via social media and split photo of a woman with botched plastic surgery and Fox. He's like a big child, I swear. I don't know why people want to cross me. I would stay out of my way. If I wasn't me because I'm going to keep winning, I think they do it for the attention. Then get more attention than they want. I told you Power was the show to watch, not Empire. LOL, forget it. Then the low IQ 50 Cent responded with what I believe he meant as an insult, but I think he just told it himself. Let me know what you all think about this one. I said to myself personally, I said, oh no, cause I let her lick my ass. She thinks I'm gay. Okay. That ignited the fire again. And Vivica said this in return. Tell you what, 50 Cent, since you keep on telling that lie, I challenge you to let's both go on the Bravo, I'm not sure what that is, and we can put this to rest. That never happened, and you know it, queen, but keep on telling them how you like it, though. Let me know when you ready, because I am. Part 2, Crazy, How You Forgot That You Paid Me To Be In Your Video And Went On The Radio Saying You Did Wrong By Me. Boy, oh boy, when that vote opens up, it's going to be good. I've got a great memory. She got you there, 50. So 50 Cent, who really licked, I'm sorry, I'm just kidding. I was going to say, who really licked your ass, 50 Cent? I'm just curious, did you get the person? Okay, never mind. Anyway, later she appeared on Wendy Williams' show squashing the beef by saying this: someone has to be the bigger person. I hated to have beef with him, but I let nobody mess with me. I ain't no punk. I told him, I will always love you. We're not meant to be together, but I'll always have love for you. I walked to him and I said, Happy New Year. It is so time for this to be over with. As far as beefing back and forth, and it was all a relief for a short time, listen, I will always have love for him. As much as we've been through, I will always have love for him. I've said he was literally like my true love, and she have said that. You know, I must admit, I think 50 Cent messed up the potential power couple with Vivica. I don't think he's able to even sustain a really good relationship because I don't know what's wrong with that boy. He need counseling or something, but his ego and pride probably won't allow him to even seek counseling, but he needs something. Anyway, but I think there would have been a potential power couple because my girl is still getting it in and she still looks good. But 50 Cent is very shallow and confused and scary. Meanwhile, Vivica, getting back to current news. Meanwhile, Vivica tested positive for the COVID, conveniently as she was supposed to be the co-host of the Emmys. But later it turned out it was a false positive. There aren't any rumors of her dating anyone, but she's still making her coins, okay? And I think the downfall of her career was when they were going back and forth and stuff like that. 50 Cent is like a big man child, yes, but he does have a huge effect on how he allows people to depict certain people whom he talk about. They tend to believe him, especially people who think like him. I don't know why they would believe anything he has to say, but that's literally how the media works. But she's still getting her coins. She's still getting these roles and things of that nature. I wish her luck. I'm still a fan, Vivica. Really, I am. Well, that's it. Let me know your thoughts below. On that note, don't forget to subscribe, like, and share. Hit that bell so you get notifications when I do post my videos. Please follow all of my pages. Love you all. Bye.